Hi, Mr. Knuckle's Music Lessons. So I'm going to do Tragically Hip, 38 years old, fantastic, fantastic Canadian band, and a great song with a great story to it. If you don't know the song, go listen to it. It's fantastic, all right? And most of you Canadians will know this song. And so it sounds like this. So that part is easy and everybody plays that part correctly, but I thought I was playing the rest of the song correctly too, and it turns out I'm completely wrong about that. Yesterday I started looking into this video before this song before I made the video, because I wanted to make sure I was kind of playing it correctly, and it turns out everybody plays it differently. You watch 10 YouTube videos, not one person plays the song the same as the last person. And I looked at tab sites, all the tabs are different. I've tried to figure it out myself and did figure out some stuff that I thought was going on. He's playing up the neck quite a bit, actually, turns out. So I went on YouTube and looked at Tragically Hip playing this song live just to make sure that I thought what I thought was correct is correct. And it turns out that, I mean, I'm still not probably playing it perfectly because the YouTube video doesn't show exactly what he's doing, but I know he's moving up the neck. That's one I wanted to confirm, that he was moving up the neck, and he is. So I think I'm getting it close, but I'm still probably not correct. I'm not going to say that I'm the only person on YouTube that knows how to play this song. So I've got it close. I'm going to show you how to play the campfire version as well as what is actually going on, at least for part of the song. Like I say, I know he's moving up the neck and I can show you what he's doing there. All right, so we're going to play the song piece by piece. I'll show you each piece and show you how to play it and show you the difference between what I think is the campfire version of it, and then show you what's maybe really going on. So the first part is just A minor, C, G. So what am I doing there? A minor, and then you roll your first finger down and pick up the first string. Whoops. And then roll it back to a regular A minor. Some people would do it this way, and then just grab that first string with your finger available. All right, I'm more comfortable doing this way. And then you go to a C. Now, in this part of the sequence, you're going to sort of accent a few notes. So the first note you're going to grab and accent is this fifth string at the third fret. And then you move to fifth string at the second fret. And then top string at the third fret. You're still strumming a little bit. I'm not really good at explaining the strumming pattern and exactly what's going on there. So I'm assuming that you're sort of an intermediate guitarist and you can kind of figure out that part of it yourself, right? But again, it's A minor, C, G. All right, so let's play that through to the first chorus, and that's where things start getting a little different than I thought they were. All right. Okay, so we're about to get into the first chorus. And again, this is where things start to get a little different. So it sounds to me, and this is what I thought was going on, it was C, G, A minor. And you can hear that little accent note right there if you listen to the song. That note is, first of all, it's still A minor, but you're grabbing the second string at the third fret. Excuse me. So that's kind of what's going on. A minor, grab that string. But, so that's the campfire version of it. I'm not positive he's playing a straight up C. As a matter of fact, I don't think he is. I think he's adding that finger to the C and the G. Although everybody on YouTube plays it a little bit differently, and I'm probably not playing it perfectly correct. Anyways, the bass chords are C, G, A minor. But the A minor, instead of doing this, what he's actually doing is he's sliding this whole, well, not the whole formation, but he's sliding up to the fifth fret. So second string, your finger's already there in A minor. You're going to slide that up. So that's a nice little sort of anchor to get your bearings. You're going to move that up to the fifth fret. You play the bottom string open, second string at the fifth fret, third and fourth string with your ring and pinky at the seventh fret. And that's definitely the chord he's playing, because I can see his arm or his hand moving up the neck when he plays that chord. Sounds very similar to this, but it's a little bit different. It rings differently. Maybe you can hear it. So the chords are C, G, A minor, and then slider. C, G, A minor. So that's the first half of the chorus. The second half of the chorus goes C, D, A minor, and then slide. However, the D is different if you want to play it campfire-wise. You don't play a full D. You actually take your middle finger off and play the bottom string open. So it's C. And actually, he's not doing that. He's playing a totally different D. And this is the coolest D in the world. C, just slide the whole formation up two frets. You can hear it sounds kind of different, but it rings differently than this D. And that's definitely the chord he's playing. So the second half of this first chorus goes A minor, slide. C, slide it up, A minor. Okay? So the first half of the chorus, C, D, A minor, slide. Second half, C, D, A minor, slide. And I'll call you out, I'll call it out to you when that change takes place. So we're just about going into the chorus here. Hey, change. Back to normal. Listen, I'm terrified of the telephone lane. Mom said you tell me the summer thing. But the temple window of the night held back the curtains for my. Okay, so we're about to get into the second chorus. Second chorus is different than the first, although it's all the same chords. So it goes A minor. Whoops. So yeah, A minor, slide to that same slide position, and then to the D, that's like the C slid up. So A minor, slide, D. And then a second time it goes C, D. A minor, slide, D, C, D. Okay? From this chorus, it goes straight into the solo. And the solo is pretty much the same as that pattern right there. I think, and I hope. All right? So let's play that part there. Back to normal. Okay, so I was a little bit wrong. The solo part is a little bit different than the last chorus. The solo goes A minor, slide, C, D. And I still don't think that's exactly right, but if you really want to hear that part, go to the very end of the song. The very end of the song is playing this pattern, and you can really hear the acoustic and what it's doing at the end, because everything else bows out except for that little slide guitar. And it really sounds like that's what he's doing. I think he actually is playing that C with his pinky there. Okay, so we're back into the verse right now, which is, like I say, always played the same way. And then at the end of the verse, it goes into that little thing that I just showed you. All right? And I'm not sure exactly when it changes. And this part of the song, because I've concentrated so much on the beginning and the middle of the song that I'm not really positive this part is correct. But I've tried this video over and over and over again, making mistake after mistake, and I don't think I'm going to try it again. So if I make a mistake at this point, it's done. All right? Mama tried the horror, okay, I just remembered that there's another chorus, and this chorus is the same as the first chorus exactly. So it's C, A minor, and it plays that a couple times, and then it goes C, A minor, and that's the way you play it out, all right? Sorry, you gotta go C, D. Something like that. I hope for the tragically hip sake that I got that close. Boys, if I got it wrong, forgive me.